ಗೈಸ್, ಇದು 2010 ಬಿಕಾಮ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರು. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 2010 ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಬಿಕಾಮ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ಬುಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಈಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಯರ್ ಬುಕ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬೋರ್ಡ್. Guys, this is a 2010 BCom 6 marks question. It is printed as 8 marks because this was a 100 marks question. It may be repeated again. It may repeat again. I will read out the question. The profit and loss account of a company for the year ending 31st March 2008 and 31st March 2009. So 31st March 2008. 8 is nothing but 1-4-2008 and 31st March 2009. This is a opening balance of profit and loss account and closing balance of profit and loss account. Okay. Now let's see what is a opening balance of profit and loss account. For showing is 20,000 rupees. And closing balance of profit and loss account is showing 30,000 rupees. Just all the thing is, you need to read the question and see which point is coming either in the debit side or in the credit side. Now let me go to the second adjustment. For the year ending 31st March 2009, provision for dividend was to be made to the extent of 50,000 rupees. So, provision for dividend is nothing but dividend payable is 50,000 rupees. So, second adjustment is also over. Transfer to reserve amounted to rupees 40,000. Transfer to reserve, which is there in the debit side. Then, depreciation written off is 25,000. And loss on sale of old machinery amounting to rupees 5,000 was debited to profit and loss account. Don't worry about debited or loss on sale of asset or plant and machinery is nothing. Amount is 5,000 rupees. Okay. Sale of furniture resulted in sale of investment resulted in a profit of 3,000 rupees. Sale of investment resulted in a profit. This is profit on sale of investment is 5,000 rupees. And sale of furniture resulted in a profit of 3,000. So both are sorry. This is also 3,000. And this is also 3,000. Instead of building, you can call it as a furniture. Okay. And a commission of rupees 4,000 received. This is an income. Commission of rupees 4,000 received. Received is nothing but what? Income. On a non-trading activity. See, if you receive commission on a trading activity, it is nothing but an operating profit. But this is a commission you receive for a non-operating or a non-trading activity. Therefore, it is considered as a non-operating income. The commission is 4,000. Here, instead of rent, I will call it as a commission. 4,000 rupees. Anything else is there? Nothing is there. So, this is all you can write dash because nothing is there. Now, which side is more? Debit side is more. So, 30 plus 40 is 70. 70 plus 50 is 120. 120 plus 20 is 140. 140 plus 10 is 150. So, 1,50,000 rupees. Now, from this 1,50,000, if you minus all these three, what you get? Funds from operation. 4 plus 3 plus 3, 10. 10 plus 10, 3 plus 2 is 1,20,000 rupees is the funds from operation. So, simple, easily we got 6 marks. Guys, please don't forget to write this. Okay, I'll leave it for another 10 seconds so that you can write clearly. See, format, you write the format and you just understand the format, identify what item is in the debit side, what item is in the credit side, easily you will get 6 marks. Okay. So this is a question given in 2012 BCom. Okay, please write this question. This is a very important question. Guys, in 2012, what question is asked? Let us see. First, let me take out these numbers. All pro forma is same. Okay. Only thing is you need to erase the numbers. That's all. Now, I will read the question quickly. From the following, but calculate funds from operation. Funds from operation. When you are asked to prepare funds, calculate funds from operation, what account we need to prepare? Adjusted profit and loss. What we have to prepare? Now, what are the items? Funds from operation for the year ending 31st December 2011. See, 31st December 2011 is the current year. If it is 31st December 2010, it is a last year. We have to check with 2010 and 11 information. If 2010 is there, then it is opening balance. Then it is opening balance. If 2011 is there, it is a closing balance. Now we will quickly refer it. Profit and loss account for the year 2011. So 11 means current year. So he is given the closing balance. So 31st December 2011 is given. Closing balance of profit is 1,60,000. Next, depreciation is given 90,000 rupees. Goodwill written off 20,000 rupees. Loss on sale of machinery is 10,000. Profit on sale of machinery 3,000. Tax provision 2,000. Dividend received as amount 7,000. Preliminary expenses written off 4,000. Transfer to general reserve is 30,000. And commission paid on non-trading activity. See, earlier problem, we had a commission received on non-trading activity as an income. But it is an expenses, so therefore I will erase this and write a commission paid on non-trading activity. It's an expenses, 10,000 rupees. And dividend payable is not there, discount on issue is not there, tax refund is not there, profit on sale of investment is not there, and opening balance of profit and loss account also is not there. Now, let us check with funds from operation. Again, debit side is more than credit side because only 10,000. Here it is large. Now, let me take the total. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 1, 7, 8. 8 plus 9, 17, 19, 22. 2 carries 2 plus 1 is 3. 3,26,000 is the total. Now, from this 3,26,000, 10,000 if you deduct it, you will get 3,16,000 rupees as a funds from operation. This is so simple question, guys. Very simple. 6 marks you will get it in 5 minutes. So this is not 2018. This is 2012 BCom question paper. Okay. Now along with this, I want to show you some of the pro forma for two ledger accounts. Let me tell you, what are those ledger accounts? Sometimes we may need to prepare an asset account
What is that?
An asset account. What type of an asset? It may be a fixed asset account. Fixed asset. What are the fixed assets? It may be land and building, plant and machinery, or furnitures and fixtures, or it may be even investment account also. Okay. So totally these are the assets which we need to prepare. So that is called as an asset account. Asset account. I am giving you the pro forma of asset account, which is very, very important from the point of examination. And this account helps us in solving the funds flow statement 14 marks question. Now let me explain you what is the pro forma of this asset account. The pro forma of this asset account having debit balance and credit side and debit side. Now let me tell you with an example. See, always assets in funds flow statement, you will be given always 2 years balance sheet. How we read in the changes in working capital, 2017-18 information was given. Similarly, for all the problems, you will be given 2 years balance sheet. In the 2 years balance sheet, asset side, you will have all assets of 2 years, both 2017 and 2018. 2017 is considered as an opening balance, 2018 is considered as a closing balance. So now, as it is an asset, always asset shows debit balance. Always asset shows debit balance of opening. So I will write it here as opening balance. Usually this will be on 1/4/2017 in my examples. Okay. It may be 2010, 11, 9, 10, 8, 9, whatever it is. Opening balance of asset should be always in the where? In the debit side. And closing balance always in the credit side. So closing balance will be always 1/4/2018. 17 is the opening, 18 is the closing. Now what we will try to do, see, I will explain in an example. Say for example, opening balance of land and building or plant and machinery, whatever the asset it is, it was 5 lakh rupees. Now the closing balance is showing 8 lakh rupees in the balance sheet. So in the balance sheet is given land and building, plant and machinery or furniture fixtures, whatever these assets, showing opening balance is 5 lakhs and closing balance is 8 lakhs. Now there is an increase in the value of the asset compared to opening to closing. Now how much there is an increase? 3 lakh rupees of increase. Now what is the point of understanding this? What we understood, how there was an increase in the value of an asset. See, there cannot be within 1 year, you cannot expect there was an increase in the asset of so much of value is revalued. We cannot expect that. Then if there is an increase in the asset value from opening to closing, definitely we might have purchased a new asset during the year. There might have been purchased a new land and building, new plant and machinery during the year. So therefore, if you have purchased, if there is an increase, 8 lakhs minus 5 lakhs, 3 lakhs, that 3 lakh rupees, you can show it as 2 bank account purchases. Am I right? Sometimes, that means 5 lakh to 8 lakhs, there was an increase, the 3 lakh rupees we purchased. See, when you buy a plant and machinery or a land and building, what is the generally you pass? Plant and machinery account debit to bank account. Land and building account debit to bank account. Generally is correct. That means when you purchase any asset, then asset account debit to bank account is right. Sometimes what happens is, when an asset is purchased, but we have not paid in cash, we paid in shares. Say for example, I am a company, purchase another company asset, land and building for 3 lakh rupees. So when I purchase that land and building for 3 lakhs, I'll tell the seller, I don't have money to pay you, but I have a shares in my hand. If you want, I'll give you shares. Then what is the guarantee we pass? Land and building is coming, land and building account debit. Instead of two bank account, I can write it as share capital. Right? So I will write it here as a share capital. This is when you purchase an asset for share capital. Instead of paying cash, you are paying share capital. Assume that there is an increase in 3 lakh rupees of asset, 8 lakhs, 5 lakhs to 8 lakhs, for which 1 lakh rupees I paid in share capital and 2 lakh rupees I paid in cash. Now this will be taken as 2 bank account. Again purchases I will write. That means there was total increase of 3 lakh rupees of land and building, for which I paid 1 lakh rupees of share capital and 2 lakh rupees of cash. You understood? Now let me take you to one more example. Okay, I will erase this. Let it be this two will be same. Now instead of opening balance is 5 lakhs and closing balance becomes 3 lakhs. Earlier it was 8 lakhs, there was an increase, we called it as a purchases. But now the same land and building or a plant and machinery which is decreased from 5 lakhs to 3 lakhs. There is a decrease in 2 lakh rupees. What is this? Is it is a loss? No, we cannot take it as a loss. We cannot assume that it is a loss. We might have been sold, right? If there is a decrease in the value of the asset, we might have sold 2 lakh rupees of asset. So that means when you sell an asset, you can write it as 2 bank account sale. Sometimes, if not land and building, if it is a plant and machinery or a furniture, there might be some amount or some value of asset or a furniture you might have sold. But to some portion of the furniture and plant and machinery, value decreased because of the usage. When you use the asset continuously, the value of the asset decreases. That decreased value, we call it as a depreciation. Am I right? So even it may be depreciation also, it is a loss. See, why I have not erased this adjusted profit and loss account is, see, depreciation I have taken in the debit side of the profit and loss account. Am I right? So therefore, from where this amount you will get it is, you will get it from the asset account. So therefore, I will write here as adjusted profit and loss account. This we can take it as a depreciation. Got it, sirs? Okay, fine. Assume that 5 lakhs to 3 lakhs is happened. 1 lakh rupees of asset is sold. 1 lakh rupees of asset got depreciated. Okay. Now, I will take you to one more example. I will take you to one more example. Same example only I will take you. Now, 5 lakhs is there, 3 lakhs is there. Opening is 5 lakhs and closing is 3 lakh rupees. Okay. Now, in this, what happened is, 2 lakh rupees of asset or 2 lakh rupees of asset which got 1 lakh rupees of depreciation during the year. During the year, what was the depreciation? 1 lakh rupees. 2 lakh was the value of the asset when we purchased. Till now, the depreciation is 1 lakh rupees. This is cost of asset. This is depreciation, and cost minus depreciation we call it as written down value. What is this? Written down value. This written down value of the asset will be how much? 1 lakh rupees. Suppose if the asset value is 2 lakhs and got depreciation of 1 lakh rupees, we write this 1 lakh rupees here. Am I right? And remaining 1 lakh rupees written down value, we sold it for the same price. Assume that we sold it for the same price. Now we write 1 lakh rupees. Now 1 lakh we sold it, 1 lakh got depreciated. But in this example, written down value is nothing but present value, today's value.
is 1 lakh rupees, but I sold it for 90,000 rupees. I sold it for 90,000 rupees. When I sell it for 90,000 rupees, 10,000 rupees, there was a loss. There is a loss of 10,000 rupees upon asset. Am I right? Now, how are we going to show this loss in the account? I will show it here as adjusted profit and loss account. Loss on sale of asset as 10,000 rupees. Now, I will show sale of an asset is 90,000 rupees. I sold it for 90,000. Because I sold an asset, written down value of asset 1 lakh for 90,000, I incurred a loss of 10,000. And this depreciation of 1 lakh, the account is got served. The account is tight. Understood? Please ask me if you have any question. Okay. Now, let me take you another example. Okay. Instead of selling it for 90,000, assume that I sold it for 1,05,000 rupees. Now, 1 lakh was the today's value. I sold it for 1,05,000. Now, 5,000 rupees is the profit I got. This profit, where I will show in the account. Now, I'll show it in the debit side as adjusted profit and loss account, profit on sale. That means, if there is a profit on sale, we show it in the debit side. If it is a loss from sale, we'll show it in the credit side. Okay. Now, I told you, this depreciation credit side, which will directly reflect in your adjusted profit and loss account. And if there is a loss on sale of asset, directly it reflects on your adjusted profit and loss account in the debit side as loss on sale of asset. If there was a profit on sale of asset, which is showing in the debit side, which will directly reflect in the adjusted profit and loss account in the credit side as profit on sale of asset. You understood? That means to say, wherever the adjusted profit and loss account showing, which goes to adjusted profit and loss account in the opposite side. Here it is showing in the credit side, it comes in the debit side. Here profit is coming in the debit side, which comes in the credit side. All of you got it? So now, asset account is clear. See, the maximum entries in for an asset account, you will get only this much. Opening balance, always asset opening balance debit, closing balance credit. If you purchase any asset, you will find it in the debit side. If you purchase for cash, you write to bank account. If you purchase for share capital, you write share capital. If you sell any asset, then buy bank account. If a depreciation happened on an asset, we show it in the credit side. If you sell any asset for a loss, we show it in the credit side. If you sell any asset for a profit, we show it in the debit side. That's about the asset account. After this, can I leave it for 2 minutes? I don't think this is helpful for you, this calculation. I'll erase it. Okay. I want to show you one more account, which is very, very, very important from the point of examination and for your knowledge also. What is that account is? Provision for taxation account. See, usually provision for taxation account, okay, you find in the liability side of the balance sheet. If you check the balance sheet, if you check any balance sheet, you will find provision for taxation in the liability side of the balance sheet. What is the provision for taxation? You have to pay tax in future for the next period, for the profits earned during the year. That means, whatever the profits you earn during the year, for which you have to pay tax in the next date or next period. So, current year, out of current year's profit, you have to pay tax in the next, beginning of the next year. Understood? That is why we call it as a liability. You set aside some profit for the payment of taxes. That itself is called as a provision for taxation. See, provision is nothing but, it's a a future liability, it is a certainly payable liability for which you have taken out some profit as a provision. Understood? Now, always liabilities, opening balance shows credit balance. Opening balance shows credit balance. And closing balance shows debit balance. Got it, guys? Opening balance shows credit balance. Closing balance shows debit balance. Assume that 10 lakh rupees was the provision which kept for the payment of taxes in the last year or beginning of this year. Beginning of this year, there was 10 lakh rupees of provision for taxation. When we need to pay? We need to pay in the current year. That means the last year tax amount of provision which you need to pay for the current year. We write to bank account, we write it as tax pay. Am I right or not? This year you thought of 20 lakh rupees that you need to pay in future, and definitely you have to take out from your profit, out of the current year profit, 20 lakh rupees, 20 lakh rupees for your payment of taxes in the next year. Understood? So this is provision for tax made. Now, if you see a adjusted profit and loss account showing in the credit side as adjusted profits and loss account, provision made. Here, provision for taxation in the debit side. Here it is in the credit side. Here it is in the debit side. All of you got it?
Yes.
Now, in the adjustment, sometimes what you will be given is, sometimes you will be given opening balance of provision for tax and closing balance of provision for tax. And in the adjustment, you will be given during the year tax paid rupees 10 lakh. Now, tax paid is given, opening is given, closing is given, tax paid is given. Now, what is to be calculated? 10 plus 20, 30, keep 30 here, 30 minus 10, 20 lakhs. This will become the opening balance. Okay, sometimes in the adjustment, you will give, instead of tax paid, you will give, during the year, provision made is 20 lakhs. You will not give this. Now, 10 plus 20 is 30, 30, 30, you take 30 minus 20, 10. This will become the balancing figure. Either this or this. Any one amount will be given to you in the, given you in the paper. So, we have to write which is given and we have to find out the other one. Got it? Now, we'll solve one question on asset and provision for taxation. Okay. Guys, this is a BBA or BBM question paper which was given in the year 2009. For us, right now, we need to understand this question. Just write on a piece of paper or a book. Now, this is a 2009 BBM question paper for 6 marks. From the following, prepare provision for taxation account and machinery account. See ya, provision for taxation account and machinery account. As it is said, okay. Now, what I do is I erase these numbers so that we can fill in the blanks. Okay. Just we need to understand the question and fill in the blanks. And okay, I'll take out the dates also. Now, what is given? Opening balance provision for taxation. Where is the opening balance of provision for taxes? 20,000 in the credit side. Closing provision for taxation in the credit side. Tax paid during the year. Tax paid during the year is 25,000. Now, out of these four numbers, already it's given three numbers. We need to find out the fourth number. That is, total is 55,000 debit side more. I will write it here, 55,000. 55,000 minus 20,000 is 35,000. This is the provision made during the year, and this is the balancing figure for provision for taxation account. See,
finished off in 2 minutes.
Now let us see the next what is given. Plant and machinery on 1/1/2001 is 5 lakhs. That means opening balance is 5 lakhs. 1/1/2001, 5 lakhs.
And depreciation on plant and machinery during the year is 50,000. Plant and machinery on 1/1/2002
is opening balance. 1/1/2002 is closing balance. That comes to 8 lakhs. So here itself you can find out. See, 5 and 8 means 3 lakh rupees definitely they might have purchased. But before that, before purchases, some other adjustments also happened. Depreciation has happened.
And a piece of machinery costing rupees 12,000 was sold for 8,000. Depreciation 7,000 had been provided on it. That means already depreciation 7,000 is provided on it. In this 50,000, depreciation 7,000 is already included. Now, what is my question is, I will address this, okay? What is told is 12,000 was the cost of asset, and its depreciation was 7,000. That means 5,000 is the return on value of the asset. Am I right? Today value. But which was sold for how much? 8,000 rupees. Means today value of machinery was 5,000, but sold it for 8,000. There is a 3,000 rupees of profit. Now for how much we sold it? For 8,000. We sold it for 8,000. And no loss is there. Instead of loss, there is a profit of 3,000 rupees. Okay. That's all about, no other entries are there. Now if you check with totals, credit side is more, so it comes to 8,58,000. Now from 8,58,000, if you minus 5,03,000, there is a 3,55,000 rupees. There was a purchase. This becomes the what? Balancing figure. Nothing is purchased for share capital. The entire difference amount, 3,55,000. We purchased plant and machinery for 3,55,000. So this is for 6 marks question. Please, you know how to prepare provision for taxation. Opening balance is given, closing balance is given, depreciation also given. But what he is saying is, during the year, a cost of 12,000 rupees of asset, its depreciation was 7,000, and return on value 5,000, which is sold for 8,000, and 3,000 rupees of profit is earned. This 3,000 rupees profit, we kept it here, and sold furniture worth of 8,000, we have taken here, or asset is taken. Okay? So this is about 6 marks question. You can copy this, okay? Okay. Now, quickly I have come to us with all the videos, 2 videos which we have shared. First, what we have prepared is statement showing changes in working capital. Statement showing changes in working capital. Second one, we prepare adjusted profit and loss account. Then we prepare ledgers. And finally, what is to be prepared? We have to prepare funds flow statement, or also called as statement of sources and applications we have to prepare. Now, I will show you the pro forma of statement of sources and application,
and we'll start with a 14 marks question
preparing for all these four different stages or steps.
Okay, now I'll show you what is that statement of sources and application, and we'll wind up this session for today. So statement of sources and application, debit side is sources, credit side is applications. Let me tell you what are the sources, what are the applications. Sources of funds.
I told you in the beginning of the video, we have three different activities of flow of funds. One is working capital, other one is profit, and the third one is financing and investing. Okay, so what are the sources of funds? What are the funds which is coming into the business, which are all the sources of the finance, which we take it in the debit side or in the left hand side, and how these sources of funds we have applied, we used it. That's why we also call the sources and uses also. Sources and uses. You got so much of source of finances and how you used it. See, the total source should equals to total uses or total applications. Now let us understand what are the different sources of finance or different sources of funds. First one is, if when you issue the share capital, you will get the funds. When you issue the debentures, you will have a source of funds. When you sell the asset, sale of asset, you will receive the funds. When you borrow loans, you will receive the funds. When there is funds from operation, means when funds you get through by profits, also you will get funds. These are the major five different sources of funds. When you sell assets, means you may sell land and building, you may sell plant and machinery, furniture and fixtures, investments. If you sell any assets, you receive the, you will get the cash or funds. That's considered as a sources. When you issue the share capital, that is equity capital, preference capital or debentures, you will receive the cash. When you borrow loan, from bank, either mortgage loan, long term loan, you will get the loan or funds. When you earn profits, through profits, when you are getting funds, that also is one of the sources of funds. Now we have different sources of funds, different sources of funds. Now how you apply these funds into different purposes, different uses, different applications. First, you can say you might have been paid taxes, you might have been paid dividends. Say dividend may be interim dividend or a final dividend. Any dividend you might have paid, tax paid, dividend paid. You might have purchase of asset. When you purchase asset, cash is going out. That means you borrowed loan, you purchase asset. You issued share capital, you purchased asset. You got profit, you paid dividends. You got profit, you paid taxes. See, you got profit, you paid. One way it is coming into the business, the other way it is going out of the business. That is sources and applications. When you borrowed loan, definitely you have to repay the loan also. Repayment of loan. When you have taken money from the debentures, you need to redeem. So that is
redemption of debentures or the redemption of preference share capital. Right? See, there is one more point, that is increase in working capital. If there is an increase in the working capital in the statement of changes in working capital, we show it in the application side. If there is a decrease, then we show it in the sources as decrease in working capital. Okay, so these sources should be equals to these applications, then only the problem, whatever we have solved, is correct. If this statement doesn't tally, tie, matches, then we might have made some mistake in some step. All of you got it, guys? So please, this is a pro forma for statement of sources and applications. To the maximum, only these many things will come. Okay, just you need to practice it for today. So when we meet up for the next class, next video, we will solve 14 marks question preparing all these four steps. Okay, statement of changes in working capital, adjusted profit and loss account, and some of the ledgers, and statement of sources and applications. Okay, thank you guys. Please share this videos to your friends and all the friends. Okay, and please subscribe my channel.